We're going to look at the vertebral column in this video, and the vertebral column has two primary functions. One is to support the weight of the body, and the other is to protect the spinal cord as it descends or ascends from the brain towards the bottom of the body. So there are five main types of vertebrae. There are the cervical vertebrae. There are seven cervical vertebrae, and they form the neck. So cervix means neck. And then you have 12 thoracic vertebrae, which form sort of between the shoulders and the bottom of the ribs. And they form the chest area. So there's 12 thoracic vertebrae. And then you have 5 lumbar vertebrae. The lumbar is sort of the lower back. And then you also have 2 sets of fused vertebrae, the sacrum and the coccyx, which we'll look at later. So let's look at each of the vertebrae separately. So I'm just going to pick up, this is a cervical vertebrae, and I'm just going to move the other 2 vertebrae out of our way. So to orient ourselves, we have our anterior part of our vertebrae and the posterior part of our vertebrae, and these are going to be lateral. So all vertebrae have some basic structures that all vertebrae have. And so we're going to name those first, and then we'll talk about how to distinguish the different types of vertebrae, the unfused vertebrae in particular. So here we have the body of the vertebrae. The body of the vertebrae supports the weight of the body, and it's anteriorly located. Here you have the vertebral foramen, which is the hole through which the spinal cord passes. And then you have your spinous process, which points posteriorly. And you can actually see the posterior processes on a person. If you look at their back, these sort of form the ridges of the backbone. So you can actually see those from the external anatomy. Now, also you can see, I'm just going to tip this a little bit, you can see these sort of flared lateral protrusions. These are called the transverse processes, And these serve as an articulation site for the rib, but also as attachment sites for muscles. So looking at this, this is a cervical vertebrae. There are 7 cervical vertebrae. And we know this is a cervical vertebrae because all cervical vertebrae have these 2 extra holes. These extra holes are called transverse foramina. Transverse because they're in the transverse process, and foramina because they're holes. And a blood vessel leading towards the brain passes through these all the way up the neck, called the vertebral artery. So again, this is a cervical vertebrae. We're going to put that to the side and work our way inferiorly. And we're going to pick up our next type of vertebrae, which is our thoracic vertebrae. We still see the same structures. You have, again, located anteriorly, the body of the vertebrae supporting the weight of the body. You have your vertebral foramen, the passageway through which the spinal cord will go. And again, pointed posteriorly, the spinous process here. You also have laterally, so you can see if we orient this. So laterally you have our transverse processes. And again, this is a thoracic vertebrae, and there's 12 thoracic vertebrae. A way to remember that this is a thoracic vertebrae is if you look at it from the side, you can see that it's somewhat reminiscent of the shape of a giraffe, right? Where here's its long snout and its little ears and the horns sticking up. So it looks somewhat like a giraffe. It's also much smaller than the next vertebrae, the lumbar vertebrae, because it supports a lot less weight because it's higher up in the body. So this is our thoracic vertebrae. Again, there's 12 of those. And then the last of our unfused vertebrae is this one here. This is the lumbar vertebrae. You'll notice that the body of the vertebrae here is much larger than the other 2 vertebrae, again, because it's lower in the body, it's more inferiorly located and supporting more weight. You still see your vertebral foramen, which is the passageway through which the spinal cord will go. And then again, what I'm holding on to is the posteriorly located spinous process. You still see our transverse processes sticking out laterally. And then, again, a way to distinguish that this is a lumbar vertebrae. One is the size of the body in particular, the body of the vertebrae. But also, again, if you look at it from the side, it looks a little bit like a moose, like the animal, a moose. Here's its sort of flattened nose, and then those funny jowl things that hang down, and its antlers that are sticking out. So it looks a little bit reminiscent of a moose. So that's a lumbar vertebrae. Now, one way to remember the numbers of the vertebrae, again, here's our cervical vertebrae, there's 7. Here's our thoracic vertebrae, there's 12. And then the lumbar vertebrae, there's 5, is to remember breakfast, lunch, and dinner. You have breakfast at 7 a.m., you have lunch at noon, and then you have dinner at 5 p.m. So 7, 12, and 5.